Now we're going to supply of the larynx. The larynx is supplied by the branches of the vagus nerve. 10th cranial nerve is two branch, that is the superior laryngeal nerve. Superior laryngeal nerve. And another branch, that is the recurrent laryngeal nerve. The superior laryngeal nerve divide into the external laryngeal nerve and the internal laryngeal nerve. This external laryngeal nerve, it is a motor, purely motor. Internal laryngeal nerve, this is purely sensory. While the recurrent laryngeal nerve, this is the mixed. Means sensory and the motor. Now first, the sensory supply. Above the vocal fold, the larynx is supplied by the internal laryngeal nerve. This nerve, branch of the superior laryngeal nerve, branch of the vagus nerve, it supply the sensory sensation above the vocal fold. While below the vocal fold, it is the recurrent laryngeal nerve, mixed nerve. Below the vocal fold, this nerve supply. One point is important, the vocal fold. This vocal fold is supplied by the both. The upper region, internal laryngeal nerve, and the lower part, it is the recurrent laryngeal nerve. So both nerve supply the sensory sensation to this vocal fold. Above this vocal fold, it is the internal laryngeal nerve. Below the vocal fold, it is the recurrent laryngeal nerve. Now the motor supply. The motor supply, all the muscles, intrinsic muscles. All the intrinsic muscles of the larynx are supplied by the recurrent laryngeal nerve. Except one, that is the cricothyroid. The intrinsic muscles, that is known as the tuning fork of the larynx, that is present on the external surface of the larynx, which is the cricothyroid, and this is supplied by this external laryngeal nerve. Mucus gland secretions of this region is controlled by the tegopalatine ganglion. This tegopalatine ganglion, if you remember, it is related with the facial nerve, and that controls the secretions of the mucus gland of this larynx, laryngeal region. Now the arterial supply, venous drainage and the lymphatic drainage of the larynx. Above the vocal fold, it is the superior laryngeal artery. Superior laryngeal artery that supply the larynx. The superior laryngeal artery, it is a branch of the superior thyroid artery. Below the vocal folds, it is the inferior laryngeal artery. Inferior laryngeal artery, it is a branch of the inferior thyroid artery. And the vocal fold, it's supplied by both arteries. The vocal fold, it is supplied, there's anastomosis between the two arteries, branches of the two arteries, superior laryngeal and the inferior laryngeal artery. While above the vocal fold, it is the superior laryngeal artery. Below the vocal fold, it is the inferior laryngeal artery, branch of the superior thyroid artery, branch of the inferior thyroid artery. Now the question is, inferior thyroid artery is a branch of which artery? Now the vocal fold, venous drainage. Above the vocal fold, it is the superior laryngeal vein that drains into the superior thyroid vein. It is the superior laryngeal vein. The superior laryngeal veins drains into the superior thyroid vein, which drains into the internal jugular vein. Below the vocal fold, it is the inferior laryngeal vein. This inferior laryngeal vein drains into the inferior thyroid vein. Now the question, where this inferior thyroid vein drains? We have discussed into the thyroid gland. Is it drains into the internal jugular vein or not? Now the next, lymphatic drainage. Above the vocal fold, the lymphatics from the larynx goes into the upper deep cervical group of the lymph node. Upper deep cervical group of the lymph nodes, that is the jugular digestive. Below the vocal fold, the larynx drains into the prelaryngeal, group of the lymph nodes, situated front of the larynx, then drains into the pretracheal, group of the lymph nodes, and ultimately drains into the lower deep cervical group of the lymph nodes. Lower deep cervical group of the lymph nodes. So, lymphatics from the larynx ultimately drains into the upper and the lower deep cervical group of the lymph nodes that are surrounding around the internal jugular vein. Now the applied aspect of the larynx. First, the injury of the recurrent laryngeal nerve. Paralysis of the recurrent laryngeal nerve. It may be on one side, that is the unilateral, or both sides, it is the bilateral. If it is the unilateral, on the same side, all the muscles except the cricothyroid is paralyzed, lost their action. As a result of which, vocal fold of the ipsilateral, same side, present in the median or the paramedian position. This is the vocal fold positions. Now this vocal fold comes into the median and the paramedian position. Space is decreased. But it is compensated by the opposite side of the vocal fold. So it is not the severe injury. Mostly this case is the asymptomatic or slight change in the voice in case of the ipsilateral, unilateral injury of the recurrent laryngeal nerve. Airways remains adequate. No difficulty in the breathing. So, only slight change in the voice because it is compensated by the other side of the vocal fold. In case of the bilateral side, this recurrent laryngeal nerve injured on the both side, all the muscles except the cricothyroid of the both sides remains functioning. Except cricothyroid is functioning, all muscles are paralyzed. Vocal fold of both sides now comes in the median and the paramedian position, both sides. And this leads to inadequate air passage. Inadequate air passage. As a result of which, there complaints of the dyspnea, difficulty in breathing, and stridor. Means, sound is hearing at the time of the respiration. This is, these two conditions becomes worse when the individual doing exercise or it is the infection of the larynx, that is the laryngitis, this post conditions worse. His voice remains good. There is no loss of the phonation. So this is the effect of the unilateral and the bilateral injury of the recurrent laryngeal nerve. Now, if only external laryngeal nerve damage, this will affect the cricothyroid muscles, only cricothyroid muscles. Will be paralyzed. And as we know, this cricothyroid muscles acts as a tuning fork. So the vocal cord on the affected side unable to tense, as a result of which there is a weakness of the voice. Its effect is weakness of the voice, and unable, the individual is unable to increase the pitch of the voice.